So how do we get him into our workplace? How do we enable what he's done for us to affect us in the workplace? Let me give you a short example from this week. Bentry has a workplace task force. You probably haven't heard of it because it's called a task force. And if you're not on a task force, you may not have heard of it yet. But the purpose of this task force is to make sure that you guys who raised your hand and said, I don't get paid to go to church, are enabled in your workplace to engage in ministry. And so I'm part of a group email, and we're all kind of replying all, talking about different things that are going on with workplace ministry. And there's a woman named Laura Oates who sent an email this week, and I was copied on it. And I read through it. I just had like 30 seconds. I'm going to go, I'm going to read through this, see what it's got. So Laura was in the hospital at Baylor. She was going to get some tests done, and she meets the person who's the receptionist at the doctor's office. And the person who's the receptionist at the doctor's office has a little can on her desk, a can for prayers. And so she strikes up a conversation and goes, okay, well, why do you have that? You're obviously a believer. Why do you have that? And this receptionist goes, well, one of my coworkers and I got together and we said, there's so much pain. What can we do? Not a doctor, not a nurse. What can we do? And so what we do is we get to work every morning at 6 o'clock and we pray. That's the Holy Spirit working through you at work. I don't know what to do. Pray. I don't know what to do. Ask God for wisdom. I don't know how to solve this problem. This electrical circuit is not working the way it's supposed to work. Ask God to tell you. He knows how electrical systems work. He knows how the human body works. But the pushback is we go, I don't know if God really wants to be here with me. I don't know if he really wants to solve this problem on his own or not. And what we do, what we end up doing, our natural default setting, is we live in a ministry prison that is the shape and size of our natural, what we believe are our natural gifts. Okay, well, I've got an education, I've got experience, I have a position at work, and I'm just gonna go out there and do the best I can. And our ministry prison becomes the shape of whatever that is. And it'll never be anything bigger. I want you to consider the possibility this morning that Jesus wants to do something at your work through you that you can't do. Let me say it again. I want you to consider the possibility that Jesus wants to do something at work with you that you can't do.